Hey guys, it's Danny. Welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I'm going to be sharing my September stash with you guys. So for this month, I am using the AC Digital's version of the Creekside collection by One Canoe Two. So I have printed off my own papers. These are on 8.5 by 11 matte photo paper, and I will leave links to all of my tips and tricks and stuff, as well as the supplies and things that I use to print off digital collections. So I will leave all that stuff down below for you guys, but I'm just going to flip through the papers really quick so you guys can kind of see the vibe of this collection. It's very outdoorsy. I love it so much. I love going on hikes. I think you guys know this. I love the stars and everything. So I love this collection and I'm so happy that I get to use it this month. This one was really pretty. The 12 by 12 was bigger. This one got cut off a little bit, but it's okay. Still really gorgeous. So like I mentioned, these are all 8.5 by 11. If I feel like I need any 12 by 12 papers, I have plenty in my stash. I'm sure I can find something that will go with this whole Creekside situation. But I just printed off 13 papers so far, and I feel like this should get me through quite a bit. You will notice as I go throughout this video and show you guys all the things that I pulled that I do have significantly less stuff to work with this month than I did last month. So I did that on purpose because Creepy Crafty Days is coming up and I kind of have to split my focus a little bit. So I wanted to keep September stash as simple as possible. I pulled these alphas. These are part of the Moonstruck collection by Pink Paisley. The colors, you guys, go perfectly. It's crazy. Like, it's got this light pink, it's got like this corally pink, and then like a dark navy, and then some gold embossing. So I thought these would be perfect, and you can see I've already used up, well, can kind of see that I've already used up some, but I'm pretty much out of the Moonstruck collection. I did a really good job of not overbuying that one and then using most of it. So I think this is one of the few things I have left from that collection. So I would like to try to get through some of these if I can. I also have this sticker book by One Canoe Two, and this one has so many stickers, you guys. I almost debated not pulling any extra stickers, but I figured just in case I wanted to do something a little bit different, I could. But this thing is brand new. I have not used any of these sheets. And there's some gold foiling in here. These are so pretty. Some of these are like planner style. There are some gold alphas in here too, which are a little bit smaller than the ones that I pulled. These kinds of sheets I probably will not use, so I might cut these apart and put them in Happy Mail. Same with like these like icon sheets. I might do the same thing there, but these butterflies are so pretty. So the deal with this sticker book is that it does have some Creekside in here, but I believe it also has, I wanna say Twilight and Hazelwood. I think those are the other names of the One Canoe Two collections. Which is fine because they all kind of have the same vibe and I think we'll go fine. So I'm excited to use up hopefully more than one page of this because I did good last month. I used up a whole page of the Chamel sticker book, I think it was. So I'm looking forward to using up some of these. And then I did go through my stash just a little bit because you guys know I am trying to use up stuff, right? So I felt like I couldn't not go through my stash. But I've got these little pluses or X's, and there are a lot of this shape in this collection. So I figured I would go ahead and grab those. I still have these cork ones that I'm gonna bring forward from last month, as well as these little phrases, just to see if I can get through them. I thought the colors of this chipboard sticker sheet would go really well. I still have a few of these stickers from, I think, Maggie Holmes Open Book. I think that is the name. I am so terrible at names of collections, you guys. But I had used these back in May, I think, and I had almost finished up the sheets. So I just have 1, 2, 3 more stickers on here. So hopefully I can get those gone. Got some dimensional, like, framey ones. And then the rest of these are also from the past collection thing, stash thing, month, whatever thing from, I think, April or something. I don't know. I had used like a big collection kit, and these are, or actually two collection kits, and these are some of the stickers that were left over from that I had just cut apart. So hopefully I can get through these. I would love, okay, so ideally I would love to use up all of these and all of three of these, and all of these, some of these, and most of these, so we shall see how I do. As for die cuts, I have my whole little box situation here, so I'll just show you really quick what I've got. So I went through my stash and I narrowed down some gold things that I thought would go well with the collection. There's like some wood grain things here, feathers, birds, hearts, stuff like that. So those are the gold ones. I also had some like brown kind of wood tone ones because this collection does have wood tones in it. So I just grabbed some of those things. There's also some black in here as well. I thought maybe I could use some like tags and tabs and things. So that's in there. This one has just a little bit of like blues and greens. So a couple more card things, some hearts, banner things, flower, little doily, card, big camera, and then a tag and a pocket. This next box, and you'll notice like these boxes are not super full, right? So I kind of did that on purpose. Yeah, because I don't want to have a ton of stuff to work with. So, whoa, dropping things. Heart, some little squares, a little tag, couple florals, bigger floral, heart. And I don't think I'm going to use this like darker corally shade. I might use the light like pinker side. I think that side's really pretty and will go maybe a little bit better than like this orangey coral. And then American Crafts, when you buy their digital collections, they give you all of the elements as well that they use to make the papers and the die cuts and the stickers and the things and all the things. So I just went through the elements packs that they had given me and I made my own little die cuts. So couple of these are like smaller versions of the cut apart sheet. I cut out a bunch of like their little phrasey things. There are a few of these like little flag deals. And I love these because they remind me of my little dymo maker. So I might actually pull that over here as well. See, doesn't that look cool? So I've got those. And then these were circles that I just used my Sizzix Big Shot to cut out. The way I did this digital collection differently from the Maggie Holmes Flourish one is the Flourish one, I pulled stuff into Photoshop and got real fancy and used my silhouette and all that stuff, which is great if you have the time, but I didn't want to spend the time doing that this time. So I just printed stuff out on my printer, my Canon printer, which is not a fancy one, it's just a regular old printer. On matte photo paper, and then I just hand cut these out with little scissors. So I use the EK Tools Precision Scissors. These are super tiny, super sharp, and they work really well for doing this kind of cutting out. And see, they look fine, right? They're not like terrible. They're perfectly fine. This also came with some journaling card cut aparts, as well as some like bigger like things. I don't know. Some like tags, and I altered the sizes of the tags to how I wanted to do that. And I didn't use Photoshop this time, I just used Google Drive. So if you guys want like a video tutorial on how to use digital collections and print them out using Google Drive instead of some fancy software, let me know down below. I'd be more than happy to do that video for you guys. It's super easy, I promise, oh my gosh. Next, I have some wood pieces. So I have a bunch of wood veneer. I hardly ever reach for it. But I figured this month would be the perfect month to do it since, again, this collection has like a lot of wood in it. So I just have all sorts of stuff. There's like some botanicals in here. There's like this deer guy, a little mushroom, bunch of leaves, some hearts, some of that. So hopefully I can get through some of these. I know I pulled kind of a lot. Hopefully we'll make it through at least some of them. And then in this last little bin right here, I've moved these two arrows forward from last month because I figured they would still go perfectly fine. I pulled four of these metal tags because I thought these would be fun to do washi samples around. And I got these from the Target Dollar Spot, I think 2 or 3 years ago. So I don't know if they still have those or not. And then this was also from Target a couple of years ago, and it's just like a gold glitter dipped leaf tag thing. So I pulled that too because I thought maybe I could use that to spruce up some happy mail. So that is everything in this little guy. As for jemmies and dimensional embellishments, I've really narrowed it down. I have some like little metal, I don't know what these are, band things, some little cork pluses, and then some little cork arrow things. This whole little section is all paper clips and stuff. These our brads, there's some like enamel flare things and like a few little rubber pieces. And then these are all of the enamel dots that I pulled for this stash. Obviously I have more in my craft room, but I really want to try to like zero in and try to use up some of these. So I just pulled a few. So I've got like some blue. I think there's some navy down in here. There's like this sagey kind of grayish green. Got some red and some blush pink, some gold and some black. So I figured this would be more than enough to get me started and get me going. And if I need to pull in more, I definitely can. It's not a problem, but I really want to try to get through these ones in particular. And then lastly, I have this little container. So I have moved these two things forward from last month. These are like little matchboxes, and this bow is super pretty. I thought it would go perfectly with the light pink in this collection. I have these two trims, so it's like a suede strip lace thing. And then this, like, I don't know what this is, lace trim, I guess? I don't know. It's from Freckled Fawn and it's adhesive, so I thought maybe I could use it on some pocket letters or something like that. I did pull several types of sequins. I've got white, black, and gray, like little flowers. And then this little container just has black and silver, and I did make a mark on here to show you guys, because after last month with the whole glitter thing and trying to show you where they were, I was like, you know what, Danny, just use a marker and mark it on the side of the thing where it is right now. And then at the end of the month, you know, you can show where you are down to. So it's right to here. If I were to turn it this way, you know, on the table, this is where the sequins would kind of stop. I've also got some more sequins and things. So these are a mix of seed beads in like green, gold, and like a deep dark brown. These are really pretty green. And then this is like a little mix that I've already made. So it's got a couple shades of green, some wood grain, brown sequins in there, and some gold. And then these are just plain wood grain sequins. So I've got like a light one, a dark one, and then just plain gold. Those are those. I would like to get through some of those. And I also have pulled this pink sequin box I got from my friend Alice. She has a YouTube channel, which I will leave a link to down below, but she had sent this to me in some happy mail not that long ago. And I think several of the colors will go really well with this whole collection. Like maybe this pink, this one, this one, this one, this one, these two. And maybe one of these, I don't know. But I didn't really have any lighter pink, like softer pink sequins in my stash, except for these. So I just pulled the whole box, because there was like, it seemed like there was like one kind of in every little three thing. So I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna pull the whole thing, it'll be fine. So hopefully I don't use up too many of those, because I love this whole little thing, but kind of the point though, right? To use up our stuff. As far as washi tape, these are from the collection. This is the only like physical item that I purchased from the Creekside, aside from the sticker book, but I don't really count that because that kind of goes with a lot of things. But I just want to show you guys the patterns here really quickly. It's a really pretty blue, really pretty like plaid color. That would be really fun for Christmas too. This one is like a lighter pinkish color. This one is really gorgeous. It's like a blue floral. So pretty. This one has those little pluses that I was talking about, but it's in all the different colors that are in the collection. And I think this one is my favorite because it's got the little trees on it and the stars, and I just love it. So these are going to be the washi tapes that I'm working with. I like that there's a nice variety of colors and sizes. So it goes all the way from thin to big and whatever, wide. And it'll be nice to layer these, and because they're all part of the same collection, I think they will all work really well together. So that is everything for my stash for September. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video and that you are enjoying this series. If you want to see all of the things I create using this stuff, make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss any of my project videos. At the end of the month, I will be sharing in empties, where I will show you all the stuff that I've used up, as well as project pictures from the whole month. And I have taken pictures of all of this stuff already. So I show you guys kind of the before of where we started, and then show you the remainder of what I have left. So if you're into that, if you love empties, if you love crafting and using up your stuff and shopping your stash, please make sure you're subscribed, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.